Let's start with a scenario. Imagine that you've released a shiny new website to the public with this funny-looking crocodile as your main image. Everything works functionally well, but suddenly you've been alerted that there is a live incident. Your observability and monitoring solutions have indicated that your application's response times are way higher. Everything is painstakingly slow and burst the website crashes. Slow websites are one of the reasons that can cause anxiety and frustration to your users. Nowadays, users are used to instant gratification due to how information is presented to them quickly. If something isn't loading quickly for them, users are very quick to leave your website and take their business somewhere else. Having an observability and monitoring solution is an excellent way to gain insights about your application's health, behavior, and performance. However, it doesn't prevent incidents, so therefore, observability needs a partner. So, what if you can prevent these performance incidents from happening in the first place? This is where Grafana K6 can help you. Grafana K6 is a powerful, developer-friendly tool that's designed and engineered with a focus on load testing, but it boasts capabilities that extend far beyond that use case. K6 started off as a load testing tool, but it can now also support browser testing, fault injection testing, and more. You can think of K6 as your reliability testing friend that can help you catch different application issues before it reaches production. Tests in K6 are written in JavaScript, a widely used programming language, which lowers down the barrier for convincing engineers to think about performance testing earlier on. Because tests are written as code, it's much easier to collaborate and maintain the tests as a team. Tests in K6 are also extensible. Through XK6, you can use various extensions that can cater to your specific use cases. So if you're interested in injecting faults into your tests, then try XK6 Disruptor. Or if you're interested in having a web-based metrics dashboard, then try XK6 Dashboard. The possibilities are vast. You can also send your test results to various output formats and backend applications, making you feel in control on how you want to query and visualize your results, whether that's to Grafana, InfluxDB, New Relic, or even just plain CSV and JSON files. Gone are the days when performance testing is the sole responsibility of an individual or dedicated experts. K6 provides the best developer experience so you don't have to worry about setting up the tooling or debugging the tests. Since tests are written in a familiar code, you just need to worry about writing the tests. Speaking of tests, let me show you how quickly it is to get started with K6. Installing K6 is as easy as ABC. We even created a video for it. I'm using a Mac, and the easiest way for me to install K6 is to use Homebrew. I've already done that, so if I want to verify that I have K6 installed successfully, I just need to type K6 version, and this should return the version of K6 that's been installed on my machine. So once you've successfully installed K6 to your machines, we can create some example script containing some K6 code. So I've created a file called script.js, and the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to import the HTTP module from K6 HTTP. Next, I'm going to export a default function. So in K6 world, anything that's within this default function will get executed by your virtual user code as often as possible, depending on the configuration that you have set. Because I haven't added any configuration yet, the default function should only get executed once. So in order for me to simulate an HTTP GET request, I can use the HTTP module and then use the GET method, and we can pass in the example URL that's provided here. And in order for me to simulate some additional think time, I can also import the sleep module directly from K6. So let me import that quickly, and I just need to call sleep and pass in the duration in seconds. So this will suspend the virtual user execution for the specified duration. To run the test, again, it's very simple. You just need to type K6 followed by the run command and then the file name. So it's gonna be script.js. And now you should see some HTTP metrics that K6 has emitted, such as the request of the duration, any requests that failed. In this case, there were none. The total iteration duration, the total number of iterations, and the number of virtual users. Now, this script is very simple, so let's spice things up a bit. Let's say I want to increase my configuration so I can have additional virtual users and increase iteration. So to do that, I can use the same K6 run command, but this time I'm going to pass additional flags. The first flag is for the virtual user, which I'm going to set to 10. And the second flag is for the iterations, which I'll set to 40. Now, when this is run, so in this example, your test will execute for 40 iterations with each of the 10 users executing the script 4 times. So you should see additional messages here that 40 iterations were shared among 10 virtual users, and you can also see here that there were 40 iterations executed. Note that you can also pass these configurations as part of your script. So to do that, we can introduce a options object. So let's type in export const options and let's set the number of virtual users to 10 as well and the number of iterations to 40. So this is quite useful if you want to run your tests as part of your CI/CD pipelines, or rather than adding it as a command line argument, you can just add it directly as part of your script. So now you just need to type K6 run and then the file name. And again, you should see here that there were 40 iterations that were shared among 10 virtual users. If we go a bit deeper with load testing, there are also other variations that you can perform. Apart from load testing, there's also smoke testing, stress testing, spike testing, and soak testing. I'll explain each one in more detail. Smoke testing checks how your application's performance if it's been exposed under a minimum amount of load. Load testing checks how your application is if it's been exposed to the typical amount of load. On the other hand, stress testing checks how your application behaves if it's been exposed to a much more heavier load than usual. Spike testing checks how your application's performance if it's been overwhelmed with a sudden increase of load. Finally, soak testing, which is quite similar to load testing, checks how your application's reliability is over an extended period of time. In K6, you can easily run different load testing types by configuring your script option to simulate the variation of concurrent users arriving into your website over time. You need to introduce a ramp up and ramp down periods. You can achieve this in K6 through the use of stages. The stages option lets you define different phases or steps for your load tests. Each stage can be configured with several virtual users and duration. So for example, if you want to simulate an average load test of 100 virtual users arriving over time into your website, we can update our script by introducing stages. So let's remove the virtual user and iterations here and replace that with stages. And then I'm going to define different steps or different phases for this particular stage. So to do that, we can specify the first stage to have a duration of, let's say, 5 minutes and a target of 50. So this first stage will simulate a gradual ramp up from 0 virtual users to 50 virtual users. And then I'm going to copy that same stage. And in here, I'm just gonna replace this to from 5 to 30 minutes. And I want to increase that to 100. So this second stage simulates a constant arrival of users for the duration of 30 minutes. Then finally, the third stage can simulate our gradual ramp down back to 0 virtual users. So far, we've been sending our results to the terminal, but what if you want to visualize this somewhere? One way to do that is by using Grafana Cloud K6. Grafana Cloud K6 is a performance testing tool in your Grafana Cloud instance. To get started with Grafana Cloud K6, simply go to your Grafana Cloud instance, go to the performance testing tab. You can either create a new project or just use the default. For this demo, I'll just use the default project. and I'm going to create a new test. So it's actually quite handy at this stage because there's different steps here or different instructions to tell you how to resolve K6, how to authenticate locally, creating a new script, and how to run a test. So we know that we've already installed K6, but now I also need to add my token in. So let me just copy that and add that to my local test run. And then what I can do next is I can basically just update my script so that it includes this additional extension. So this just ensures that the test run locally will connect to Grafana Cloud K6. So let's add that after stages. And maybe let's give this a much better name as well. Test run demo. Okay, so now instead of running the test locally, you have two options of doing it. The first option is you can type K6 cloud and instead of K6 run and then the file name. So this will essentially run your test to the Grafana K6 cloud instead of running it locally. Or the other way of doing it is if you want to run your test locally, but you want to output the results to Grafana Cloud K6. So you can do that by passing in the out flag and then typing in cloud and the file name. Okay, so with that option, you can see that the execution is still local, but now the output is being sent to the cloud. So you can either follow the URL that's being printed here, or if I go back to my Grafana Cloud K6 instance, go to my default project, and you can see that there is now a new test run that's being created. When the test is finished, you get a visual representation of your test results, and you also get insights of your performance overview over time, among other things. This is just the beginning of what you can do with K6, but hopefully I've convinced you enough that K6 is a modern reliability testing tool that aims to provide the best developer experience. Observability needs a partner, and if you're already using Grafana, K6 could be the missing puzzle in your Grafana stack. If you want to know more about the K6 API, how to simulate different use cases, or you just want to know more about recommended practices, then check out k6.io/docs for more information.